for the longest time, Tata Motors has been spoken about as one of the cheapest Nifty 50 names, arguably the cheapest auto name as well. The crown jewel in the Tata Motors stable was JLR, which is now turning out to be a bit of a drag on the automaker, though I don't know if the domestic CV segment is not either. But the product lineup, which was already starting to fall behind when geopolitical events like Trump's trade war and increasing uncertainties over Brexit have put another spanner in the wheels. Yatin Mota is standing by. With all that's slowing down Tata Motors, well, it seemed like a juggernaut ready to roll, Yatin, by virtue of the valuations that it was trading at. But somehow, it's not been able to move from gear one to gear two.
Clearly, Neeraj, and that is the reason why we are talking about this today, that Tata Motors, being the cheapest frontline auto stock, is the weakest of all of them. And clearly, when other auto companies are doing well at record highs, Tata Motors is hitting fresh 52 weeks low in trade. And more importantly, even after the kind of cracks that we saw post the earnings of the third quarter, we still have the stock which is struggling even to cross those lows. In fact, it is drifting downwards to that 350 mark. So quite weak on that front. But if you look at the US sales, which was the latest data point post which we saw a 5% fall, the total JLR sales were down nearly 2% for the US markets. However, Jaguar sales were down 37%. And you will have the breakup of the models coming in. So the Range Rover Sports, Range Rover, their hot selling model Evoque sales were down 51% in the US. Discover Sport sales were down 39%. Of course, this is to do with the fact that there were new launches, so we had a compensation coming in from the new Discovery and the new Velar. So these are the two models which are doing well in the marketplace, but still we have their flagship models sales fall significantly in the month of February, and probably that is the reason why we saw a fall yesterday. But look at this is the geographical breakup of how sales really shape up or add up for Tata Motors JLR entity. North America and Europe constitute nearly 50% of the sales. Some sales come in from the UK and China, and the rest of the world constitutes to about 20% of total JLR sales. But let's talk about North America and where the problem really is. We have, not only a possible trade war, but also the overall, US sales weakening. So there is a probability of a trade war which can come in. UK, that is an important market for JLR, the home market. Auto body expects auto sales to drop 5 to 7% in 2018. And this is a forecast which is talking about a two-year decline. So, 2017 car sales went down, 2018 car sales are expected to be quite weak. And in fact, yesterday we had the UK PM make a statement that UK has to face hard facts on Brexit. Probably it's not only about currency volatility, but it's also about trade pacts and how it trades with the European Union moving forward. And that is something I think the market is still quite wary about. Coming to China, and slowing economy again may hamper growth. We have seen some tapering off of growth coming in there. And JLR being a luxury car maker, a slight bit of slowdown also impact the sale multifold times. So a slowing economy really does not augur well for an entity like JLR, which gets bulk of their margins and realizations from the Chinese market. And more importantly, if you look at the global scenario, we have the electric cars, which may gain market share from the luxury car segment, given the fact that the pricing of these electric vehicles is quite high. Probably they compete with these luxury car makers. And the recent currency volatility, again, might impact the overall margins for the JLR entity. Of course, we have the overall Brexit overhang also, and the UK PM said that in certain ways our access to each other's market will be less than it is now. So clearly, an exporting company, JLR from the UK, and then how it deals with the EU, how it deals with the US is something important that we're watching out for, because those regions are nearly 50% of JLR sales. And President Trump also warned the EU that if the EU wants to further increase their already massive tariffs and barriers on US companies doing trade there, they will put a tax on their car which freely pour into the US. So, we have a lot of political issues which clearly are impacting not only the, consumer sentiment, but the political sentiment as well. So, that doesn't augur well really for the luxury car markets. And, a few charts to show in This is the 12-month chart of Tata Motors at a 52-week low, down 25% on a one-year basis. And you know what surprises me is the analyst recommendation, and the next slide will talk about that. Most of them have a buy rating. You will not see probably any sell rating, only two sells to 30 buys. So 70% of the analysts, or a little over that, you know, have a buy rating on Tata Motors, and most of them have target prices in excess of 500 rupees, as you can see it on the screen. So, you know, despite all of that, FY18, FY19 EPS in excess of, 40, 45 rupees, and still the stock is struggling. Clearly, all of these geopolitical issues and global issues are a key hangover to the stock of Tata Motors.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised. The only thing is, for the last 18 months, I think it's not just a 52-week low. It's probably a 20-month low that Tata Motors is trading at. And if there is not a significant price correction, which it is in the first place, by the way, but there is a substantial time correction. For the longest time, we've seen analysts being bullish on this one as the cheapest Nifty auto company, but that hasn't really helped spur any kind of buying in Tata Motors as well.